Good morning, children. Children, we will do question answers of this chapter, lesson 7. Okay, the first question was, what are omnivores? I have taken some questions from your textbooks and some extra I have given for your knowledge. Okay, now what are omnivores? As you know, animals that eat both plants and flesh of other animals are called omnivores animals. So, that means which type of animal they eat this flesh and plants? We are talking about deer. Deer eats both flesh and plants of plants also. Even we humans are also omnivores. How? We also eat flesh. That means we eat meat. We eat eggs. Okay. That means we are eating meat. We are eating fish. We are eating. We are eating flesh of other animals. And also we are eating plants. So we are also in that category. We are also omnivores. Okay. So answer is the animals that eat both plants and flesh of other animals are called omnivores animals. Now number two. What do you mean by extinct animal? Now, as I told you in previous module, extinct animals are the animals which are not found anymore. They must be living long years before they must be living, but now we don't find them anymore. They are called this extinct animal. That means, हम अभी उसको देख ही नहीं पा रहे हो जानवर बहुत साल पहले शायद जीते थे बहुत साल पहले शायद होंगे अर्थ में पर अब वो लुप्त हो गए हैं अब वो नहीं है सो दीज एनिमल्स आर कॉल्ड एक्सटिंक्ट एनिमल्स दिस यू शुड लर्न इट ओके वी सी सम मोर क्वेश्चंस नाउ चिल्ड्रन वी हैव हियर थर्ड क्वेश्चन इज व्हाट इज डिफरेंस बिटवीन कार्निवोरस एंड हर्बिवोरस नाउ यू नो कार्निवोरस आर द एनिमल्स दैट ईट ओनली फ्लैश ऑफ अदर एनिमल्स दे आर कॉल्ड कार्निवोरस एनिमल्स लाइक लायन टाइगर चीता वे generally they hunt and they eat other animals okay they don't eat any plants nothing so these are called carnivorous animals now herbivorous animals they are totally opposite of carnivorous animals how animals that eat only plants are called herbivorous animals like squirrel snake caterpillar yes they are called herbivorous animals so both have totally opposite difference carnivorous eat only flesh of other animals Herbivores eat only plants and they don't eat any flesh. Okay, so this is very easy to remember. Both are totally opposite. Omnivores, what omnivores do? They eat both flesh and plants. Scavengers, what they do? They eat all decaying animals, decaying bodies. Okay, so these are the four differences of animals we have seen in the chapter. We'll shift to other questions. Okay, our fourth question is, in different purposes, animals use their tail. Now, already in previous module, I have shown the different purpose for which animal uses its tail. Children, again I tell you, these things are not given in your textbook. It is not differentiated in your textbook, but I have already differentiated so that it becomes easy for you to understand. Right? Now, what is the first thing? Communication. Communication means what? How they communicate with each other. Animals communicate with each other with the help of their tails or they can I talk about dog. When the dog is very happy, it will wave its tail. When the dog is afraid, it will put its tail down. That way it will communicate with message. That means it will show its emotion. Balance. When we talk about balance, already we have gone through the chapter that kangaroo and squirrel their tail helps them to balance because their tails are made in different way that helps them to move from one place to other with a hand, keeping balance of their body. Next, locomotion. Locomotion means to move. That means if we talk about a fish, this tail helps the fish to move from one direction to another. It helps them to change the direction. Right? That is called locomotion. Attack. If we talk about scorpio, when it sees its enemy, it will attack with its tail. It will give a dose of poison to the enemy and run away from there. This way, it helps them to save their life. So, the tail helps them to attack their enemy. They protect themselves with the help of their fly away, risky flies from their body. So this way the tail helps them to get safe from the insects. So these are the six parts, how six purposes for which the animal uses its tail. Children, we have completed our question answer session here. You go through the chapter, you learn the question answers properly, and even if you have any doubt, you can again come back, you can refer to your teacher for this. Okay.